Matt.
Hello.
What do you think of Matt? Do you like him? What do you think he's thinking about right now? As you can see, Matt plays the guitar. I think he's mad about his guitar. After all, he never seems to go anywhere without it. Ever since he heard Abbey Road by the Beatles, it's been a huge influence on him. This is Zach. Zach is unsure about his future. To earn a bit of shit, Zach works at Pizza. But he's not Jason's hair. This is Georgia. Georgia is a major chocoholic. She's also terrified of spiders, with their long legs and hairy bodies. I don't like them either. I've noticed something with Georgia. I think she has a slight OCD, as the main thing that bugs her is a plug switch being on when there's nothing plugged in.
I don't know why, it doesn't look right. I have to turn it off.
That's it. This is Chris. Chris is an absolute joke. Chris is a joke. He makes everyone in class laugh at his antics. The strange obsession for Rick and Morty and Star Wars.
It's the Force.
This is Mikkel. The fabulous one. Mikkel has a hidden fish tank in his bedroom that his parents don't know about. He's also one of the only people in our class to be on television.
Look at his face.
This is Jess, but everyone calls her JP. JP loves musical theatre and to party. She's quite a rebel. She wants to go on the man for 3 days.
Well, my dad thought it was at my mum's. My mum thought it was at my dad's. But really, I was at Mate's hospital. I really like her.
What do you do now?
This is a play about us. It's about our brains. It's about all of you. 20 years ago, scientists thought that teenage brains were the same as adult brains, like really rubbish versions of them. Scientists thought that teenagers were just crap adults. Most people thought that teenagers were just crap adults. In fact, most people still do. This is Alex. He's 19. I know, he looks young, right? So then scientists started using these machines called MRI machines to scan people's brains, and they found out loads more about them. They found out that teenagers aren't actually crap adults, and they found out that our brains are different for a reason. Now that's okay, and they're meant to be like that. In Alex's free time, he attends raves on the London Underground. He also thinks he's the funniest person to be around in class.
Well, I know.
So scientists now know that teenage brains are different for a reason. But if you go ask people in the street, or teachers, or bus drivers, or politicians, or parents, or the security guards that follow us around in stores, I bet they don't know that. We know that and think you should too. This is my main man, Mateus. Mateus is a total bad man. He once spotted David Cameron. He's also my dealer.
Hey, shut up, bro. Let's get looking.
Mateus' brain right now, there are 86 billion neurons. A neuron is a cell that sends information. In your brain right now, there are 86 billion neurons. Everyone has 86 billion neurons. Even Mikkel.
Wait, what?
In Matt's brain right now, there are neurons sending information like playing the guitar. Whenever you think of something, or do something, or look at your phone, or dance to some sick tune, or think of someone really fit.
Like Kim Kardashian, boy.
Whenever you do anything, your neurons get connected up. They get connected up by these things called synapses. This is Micah. Micah thinks he's 6'6". Naturally, he's 6'4". He makes slogan jokes, and I often get the blame for them. He also loves to sing Susan Boyle's I Dream a Dream into his hairbrush.
I dream a dream when time goes by. That
was terrible.
By the time you start puberty...
Like Zach.
No, it's like you.
By the time you're like Zach, there are some parts of your brain that there, some parts of your brain that have too many connections. Loads and loads and loads of synapses. It's called sprouting, and your brain's like really messy. When you're a teenager, you've got more connections to some parts of your brain than you'll ever have again. This is Charlie. Charlie is a right geezer and a total ladies. He considers himself as British as fish and chips. But we sort of seem as a cockney old man from the 1960s.
Because I can do my Michael Caine impression, right? And not many bloody people I can do that, right? But I can. Oh, yes.
And I'm Jack. As you can see, I'm the coolest and most gorgeous one in. Look at us. What do you think of us? What do you think we're thinking about right now? Do you want to see? Think of all those connections you're making right now while watching us. Who's your favourite?
Oh, that's got me.
That's me. Who'd you sit next to on the bus?
Oh, that's me as well.
Well, who would you have been friends with when you were our age?
Oh, well, that is me.
Who's always getting into trouble?
Who's in love? Oh, Sam.
Who do you think tells their parents to fuck off? Locked away in their bedroom. Look at us. Look at us. Look at us.
They never knock. I'm a 16-year-old girl. I need my privacy.
Well, I like to call it. I mean, it's looking more like furniture than that, so it might need to be. My dad's like to help scrape me living on an armchair. And I mean, I heard him say to my mum, oh, an armchair, we got this, that's good already. Oh, fuck it, let's just rack it around the child. That's right. And a wall type, I'm not selling Zolga for you, but plenty of wood because it has that in capital. But I don't know what that is. Trust me, that's that.
In my bedroom, I have a lot of things. Mainly, I have a PlayStation 1, PlayStation 2, PlayStation 3, and a PlayStation 4. I also have an Xbox, an Xbox 360, and an Xbox One. I also have a Nintendo 64, a GameCube, and a Nintendo Wii. I also have 7 guitars, 2 of which are acoustic, and 1 is a bass.
I bet you don't care what's in my room, but I'm going to tell you anyway. So, before you get to my room, obviously you have to go through the door, and on the door it says, do not enter. No, seriously, do not enter. So yeah, if you get to my room, you will see a wall full of shoes. Shoes. And yeah, I got a fish tank. Some people like fish. Well, some people like dogs and cats. I like fish, and I got a tank for it. Well, mine was the fish, but yeah. I'll tell you
Well, my room is mostly tight. Except on the corner for the round room stuff where the dental clothes and stuff that I've been using throughout the week. Also placing cards. In my room I have an Xbox One, Xbox 360, PlayStation 2, Pop Funkos, tons of graphic novels, and a lot of Star Wars stuff. So it's pretty nerdy, just like me. Because my corner's a mess, my mum over-exaggerates and moves me to tidy my room. But she barges in like she's just won the lottery, knocking me out the door. So she starts swearing. She hits me back with some cold-blooded, savage, guilty stuff. And I feel awful. Thing is, it's my room. She should just knock, and I wouldn't have to argue about some stupid-ass shit. I do love my mum, though, especially as she painted my room's walls. My walls are coloured blue, grey, and white. I like my daddy granddad also, because they brought me a bed. I can actually get some sleep and escape from this crazy world.
In my room, I have an Xbox One, an Xbox 360, a HP desktop computer, a MacBook, an Anakin Skywalker's Force FX lightsaber. Yeah. I have some Darth Vader comics like, welcome Chris. As you may have guessed, I am a nerd. Anyway, there's some other stuff in there, but it's pretty boring. And my parents always come in my room without knocking. It's like they think I'm watching porn and wanking in there all the time. No, seriously, they think I am. I see my dad walk in with some predator outside and push my mom only sees and heat me. You know, they're nicer.
Oh,
sure you had to make a sandwich.
To make a pizza, a pizza.
Today I'm going to show you how to play some basic guitar chords.
How to exfoliate with a banana. Come on, I like it.
To shred on guitar.
To roll a fat joint.
And to pull the bird. And control our Beyonce.
Imagine you could open the door in my head and see what happens every time I learn something new. Because I swear down, right now, it feels like I do something new every day. Like learning a new song, or making a new film, or buying new makeup, or finding that place on White Hot Lake that's the best chips I've ever tasted. Chips are so good. You'd see a whole load of my neurons getting connected in a way they never have before. And every time I do the same thing, the same connections happen, again and again.
Hello! Welcome to my YouTube tutorial. This week I'm going to show you guys how to draw Eminem's face. It's really simple. Firstly, start by drawing the outline for the head guide.
In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a sandwich. First, make sure you've got two slices of bread, butter, and mint fillet, and enough.
So first of all, you need to stretch it out to the size you
want. Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to play some basic guitar. The first chord I'm going to teach you today is the C chord, the most basic chord you can ever really learn on guitar.
First of all, get your banana.
No, it's not about it. Just flip the switch, right?
Forget about scales, focus on single notes, scales and a lot of repetition.
Make sure you record it on her. Yeah.
Make sure that the lady in question paints the building.
I am doing my giveaway and all the links will be down below.
Thanks for watching!
Chris!
What, Dad?
Have you seen my shirt?
No, Dad.
My shirt! I'm late for work!
I haven't seen your stupid shirt.
Are you sure? Can it just come in and go?
No, Dad, I haven't got this stupid shirt. Oh, fucking shit.
Exactly, and I work for some council.
Well, that's my job for you, I'm a clue. Doesn't call me.
Prince is really improved at how he uses it. I'll still worry about him.
I am very proud of Mikael. He's a hard worker, and I can't wait to see where he goes next.
I don't know, I need to introduce his major voice.
There isn't anything my boy wouldn't do for anyone. In fact, the other day, he helped an old lady cross the road.
Alex! Alex!
opinion, I'll ask.
Does that sound much like you live under my roof and it's my roof? My roof! Just get out of here!
I'm paying for it!
I'm paying for it!
What is that?
Nothing.
SF isn't, I told you. Not to get, isn't it?
But all my friends have them.
I don't care, it looks horrible.
You know what? My friends like it, so I'm keeping it.
Don't talk to me like that.
I'm 16, Dad! Do have the fuck I want!
You see my keys?
No, why do I see your keys?
You always do this.
Always do what? Fuck off blaming me for everything.
You need to sort your attitude out, you bastard.
Yeah. Fucking, you're 5'9", I'm 6'2".
You need to sort your attitude out. It's not for me. I didn't raise you like
this. Go away!
Oh, look at you looking like an idiot.
Chaz?
What's the sun stain on your
wall? Oh, I don't need to know that, Dennis.
I thought I told you, it's not even trash all over the floor.
It's just the thoughts of that, what do you want me to do about it?
Well, I expect you to clean it up by tonight.
Divided into different parts, and so
basically, the limbic system is a complex system of nerves and networks in the brain. And that includes the olfactory bulbs, the hippocampus, and the amygdala. That's the main bit, and that's the bit that does the rewards and stuff. And then there's, hold on, I'll just read these out. There's the anterior thalamic nuclei, fornix, columns of fornix, mammillary body, septum pellucidum, habenula pubica, cingulate gyrus, parahippocampal gyrus, limbic cortex, and midbrain, for fuck's sake!
Okay.
Emma, can you put the lights on the audience, please? Hello! How are you? Are you okay? Are you okay?
Yes!
Are you enjoying the show?
Yes!
Do you want to play a game?
Yes!
Do you want to play a game?
Yes!
Now we're talking. So, this game is called... Wait, before I start... Hello, what's your name? Hello everyone, this is Harmony, and Harmony wants to play a game. Okay, this game is called Never Have I Ever. This game is called Never Have I Ever. So, what I want to do is find the person with the best limbic system in the room. And because you're all sitting down looking sensible, acting like you've done anything stupid before, which I know you have, well, I have, even Georgia has. So we are all going to get up. No, not now. I will tell you when to, and we all get up and we will say, never have I ever something. If you've done it, you stand up. If you haven't, you sit down, you're out of the game. So yeah. Do you want to do a test round?
Yes!
Do you want to do a test round?
Yes!
Good. So, never have I ever watched a play. Wait. You all got to be honest.
Everyone stand up.